Hi friends, today I am planning to show you some very basic hand embroidery stitches and how to make use of these stitches in our day-to-day life or in our practical life. So before starting this project, I would like to show you some materials that are required for doing this project. The first one is the fabric, of course, and that goes without saying, and we can use any type of fabric for that matter, like cotton, rayon, silk, linen, etc. And then comes the embroidery thread. This embroidery thread also comes in cotton, silk and the like. This embroidery thread, it comes in like this. This thread consists of 6 strands, and you can separate the strands while doing the embroidery. Generally, we do embroidery with 1 or 2 strands at a time because that gives a neater look. But today, while starting, I will start off with the whole thread as it is, that is using all the 6 strands. And as we progress along the video, I'll be reducing the number of strands so that you can get a better idea about the look of the stitches. And you have these spools also available in the market. They are the silk threads. And then the other materials needed are, this is the embroidery ring. It consists of 2 parts like this. And this is for keeping our cloth or fabric very firm while we do our embroidery work. And then comes a pair of scissors and needles. Talking of needles, I have the complete set like this so that it becomes easy for us to choose the different needles according to the number of strands that we are using. So since I am not making any particular design, I have not kept any stencil or anything like that ready. But in case you are very good at freehand drawing, you can simply draw a design over the fabric on which you can make the embroidery, or then you can use a stencil, or maybe you can use a white carbon and then trace the design on the piece of fabric. So I'll just give you an idea of the stitches that I'm going to show you so that you get a better picture. The first one is the running stitch. So this is the most basic form of any embroidery stitch. And then comes the threaded running stitch. It is just a modification of this running stitch. Then comes the kantha stitch. This is a traditional embroidery stitch that perhaps originated from the eastern parts of India, like Bengal, Odisha, and even it was practiced in some parts of Bangladesh. So this kantha stitch also basically contains running stitches only, but here the small running stitches are used to fill up the design. Here I have made a rhombus, you can see this, and here I have used this small running stitches to fill up this design. And then comes the back stitch. You can make out the difference between the back stitch and this running stitch just by looking at it, because this is a continuous stitch, whereas here you can see the fabric in between. If here I have used the 6 strands, but in case you use 1 or 2 strands while doing the back stitch, it will look more or less like a machine stitch. And then comes the chain stitch. You can see it is in the form of small chains, or you can see that it is in the form of small tiny braids. And then comes the lazy daisy design. That is, the lazy daisy stitch is an extension, or it is a modification of this chain stitch, and it comes in very handy when you make some small flowers like this, or small leaves. And then comes this stem stitch. As the name suggests, the stem stitch is generally used in embroidery for making stems or tiny branches. But all these stitches as such can be used for different purposes. I will get back to that as we go along in the video. So on this side, I have some other stitches like satin stitch, buttonhole stitch and all that. I'll be coming to that in my next video, because otherwise this video is going to be too long. So let us start our project. So for that I'll fix the embroidery ring. See, this is how you fix your this is how you fixed your cloth to this embroidery ring, and then you have to tighten this, and you just pull the fabric from all the sides, and your fabric is firm inside this frame, and you can do your embroidery work easily. So here I am using all the 6 strands, and then I have put a small knot at the bottom like this. Now I'll start with the running stitch. For that I'll just poke the needle from behind the, from underneath the fabric to the top like this. See? And then I will poke the needle from top to the bottom. So you can see a stitch right like this. So this is our running stitch. Now from the bottom, I'll take this out and then again poke it inside. So I'm doing it very slowly so that you get a hold of things. Again, I take it from below like this and then from top to bottom like this. So you can see tiny stitches like this. So if I repeat it somewhat quickly, I'll just show you. Now while you are inserting from top to bottom, you can just take it like this itself. See, I'm again inserting. I will take it in one go like this. Poke it inside and take it out like this. So now I'll show you how we have to. I'm just when you get a hang of things, you can do a lot of running stitches in one go. So this over, and then I'll poke the thread inside, and then I'll show you the back side so that you know how to finish off this stitch, and then I will just take it inside like this and take the thread through this loop. And now I have the knot here and our stitch is secured, and we'll just cut off the extra thread. So this is the running stitch. So make sure that you poke the thread inside and outside at equal distances so that you get a similar stitch all over. So this is the running stitch. Now I will show you where we can use this running stitch. Now suppose you want to join 2 pieces of fabric like this. So you can see that these are 2 separate pieces, and for that you can just do a running stitch like this, and then you keep it for sieving under a sieving machine. Because if you are quite new to a sieving machine, then it so happens that these fabrics, they will slip out of position, and you get a very bad stitch. So it is always better that you hold the 2 fabrics together using this running stitch, and then you can be confident of using the sieving machine and you get a straight stitch, and then these 2 pieces of fabric will become a single unit like this. And then another use of this is for making a gather or for making a frill. I'll just show you. This is a piece of fabric like this, and I have just made a running stitch like this. See, this is a piece of strip of cloth, and I have made a running stitch. Now I'll just gather it like this so that it forms different. Now you see, you can make it, make the frills as you wish. It depends on the amount of frills that you have, whether you want to have big frills or whether you want to have tiny frills. Now let me just attach it to a piece of cloth. So if you want to attach this frill to another fabric like this, we will see. We will adjust the length like this. So this is okay. You see, this frills are okay for this width of the fabric. So what I have to do is, I'll just close it here. I'll put a knot here, and this stitch, it will remain like this. So now you see, this we have formed a beautiful frill like this. Now, as I told you, you take these two fabrics and you run a, you first do a running stitch over this, and then you can secure it using a machine stitch. I'll just show you a sample here. See, these are the two fabrics I was telling of. This I made the frill using the running stitch, and then I secured it to this. You can use either machine stitch, but here of course I have used another embroidery stitch for joining the two pieces of fabric, that I'll be telling you how to do that later on. So this is the, it will look something like this. So you can make such frills, and you can attach it to the neckline, you can attach it to the bottom of your skirts, midis. So that's it. Now let us start with our second stitch, that is the threaded running stitch. Okay, for that I have already made the running stitch, because that is the base for this threaded running stitch. And here again, let me use 6 strands for this. I'm using the 6 strands because the stitches will be looking very bold. So now what I have to do is, again I have to poke the thread from the inside like this. And see, now what I am doing is, I'll just poke the thread under this thread like this. I won't be touching the cloth here, just under the stitch, okay, like this, from right to the left, and then from left to the right. I'll just hold it like this. I'm not touching the fabric here, only I'm using the thread under the stitches. So now from right to left, and then we go from left to right. Again from right to the left, from left to the right. So this is the method of doing this braided stitch. So I reach towards the end of the design. Now again I'll poke the thread like this, and then towards the back side I'll make a knot. And see, our braided the threaded running stitch, it will look something like this. And you can see that it forms a zigzag pattern. So for better effects, you can use 2 color strands for this particular stitch. Now I'll show you some areas where I have used this particular stitch. The first one is this mask. This was handmade by me long ago, and I have first made a horizontal diagonal lines like this, and then I made use of this threaded running stitch for this purpose. So talking of this particular mask, I already posted a video in this regard, and for that I'll be sharing the link in the description box. You can just have a look in case you are interested. So I'll show you another item that I made using this particular threaded running stitch. So I bought a sari. You can see the sari was something like this. It contained bold floral designs like this. Then I made use of this particular embroidery stitch. and it turned out to be something like this. You can see, and here of course I have used some sequins also in between to give a additional look. I have worn this saree in one of my uploaded videos. I will give you the link of that also, so that you can get an idea how it looks like when we wear it. Okay, now let us come to our next item, and that is the kantha stitch. So for this kantha stitch, again I have done a running stitch in the outline. I have given the border in black color. Now I have put some lines inside so that I can fill the design with another color. So for that I will be using green color. So here I have reduced the number of strands. I have kept it at four strands. That is, I have used two strands and then I have doubled it, so it has become four strands, and I have put a knot at the bottom. Now I will be using this four strands to make the design. So this is again running stitch. I'll make small running stitch, and you have to fill up the entire space, that's all, as close as you can get. So in case you feel that the space in between the stitches is more, you can do a back stitch like that. You can just go to the back to maintain the distance, and then repeat just like any other running stitch. Now I completed doing the running stitches in green color. Now I'll just start with the red color. Again I use four strands here. The method is the same. You have to use small running stitches to fill up this design. So you have to keep doing this running stitch over and over again till the entire space is covered. Now I almost covered the entire design with the running stitches. Now I'll just poke the needle inside like this, and I'll show how to finish. So I'll just take the thread from one of these stitches, running stitches, and then I'll just take the thread through this loop and I will tighten it. So our stitch is secured. So the remaining threads that we see here, you can just cut it off using a scissor, so that our back surface, back area also remains neat. So this is the finished design. So I have already done this design here. Yeah, this is another kantha stitch. So now I'll show you where these designs can be used. This is one saree. This of course is ready made. So you can see the entire saree is made up of this kantha stitches, kantha embroidery. And here you can observe that all the stitches, most of the stitches here are in running stitches. See, just running stitches employed here. Here of course they have made use of another stitch. This is the chicken work or the shadow work that I'll be discussing about that in my next video, or maybe some other videos. But other than this particular stitch, all the stitches used here are the running stitch. You can see here for the leaf, they have used a border design like this, again running stitch, and inside area also they have filled the complete leaf with this running stitch. So this is the ready-made item. I'll show you one item that I made. So this is a normal bag, shoulder bag or a tote bag, whatever you can call it. And then it is made of fabric, and here for a change I made the handle using crochet and wool. And here you can see that this particular design I made a simple design using a stencil, and then I finished the design using kantha stitch. So it is nothing but simple running stitches, but they are used to complete a design, and it looks very attractive. So this kantha stitch is also used for quilting purpose. That is, old sarees or old bed sheets, they are connected together. I mean, they are joined together by the process called quilting, and this is done using this kantha stitch or simple running stitch. I'll be showing you that also in one of my videos that will be coming soon. But as of now, we'll proceed with our next stitch, that is the back stitch. So now I am starting the back stitch. So for that, again, I'm taking the needle from the bottom to the top. And the first step is similar to the running stitch, like this. And then I will take the, till this step, it is similar to the running stitch. But now, instead of poking it forward, towards the line, I'll just poke it backwards. That is a back stitch. So, from here to the point where I had inserted it. So, this is the back stitch. See? Now, again, I'll poke it from inside. And again, to the back side. So this is the back stitch, and the difference you can make out here, you can see gaps, whereas here this is a continuous stitch. So this stitch is a very strong stitch, and you can use this stitch also for joining two pieces of fabric together using this simple embroidery stitch. You can use this for covering any particular design also. Like instead of using this stitch, you can use this particular back stitch also for that purpose. So now our back stitch will look something like this. It forms a continuous stitch, and then I'll show you how to secure this. We'll just poke this like this, and I'll make a knot, and then I'll cut the excess thread using a scissor. So now, as I told you, this stitch can be used for joining two pieces of fabric together. You can see these are two pieces of fabric. Here I have joined most of this portion. I kept a small portion remaining. I'll show you how to do this. So I have attached, I kept these two pieces together, and then we will assume that this is just a single piece and do the embroidery. That's all. So I am just poking it from under the fabric to the top, and then I am doing a back stitch. See, then I will just take it out like this, and then again back stitch. And this method is repeated till you complete joining both the fabrics. So you have to just assume that the two pieces of fabric are a single unit, and you have to continue doing this embroidery. So that's it. I'll show you. So in case you are not satisfied, you can do one more running stitch. That is, first you did from this side, you can do from here to here. Then you can be assured of the fact that this is quite firm, and it is as good as any machine stitch. You see? So here I have used this different color for joining, because I wanted to show it to you. Practically speaking, you should be using the same color, of the fabric, so that it doesn't show. Okay, so the next one is the chain stitch. For that, I'll use two strands. So as I told you, two strands or a single strand is generally used for making any particular design, because they look elegant. Chain stitch is also a very simple stitch. I'm taking the thread like this. Now what I have to do is, I'll just see, and this thread, I am taking it from left side to the right side under the needle. You can see I'm taking this thread under the needle, and I'll just pull it. So a small chain or a small braid is formed here. Again, you can see I'll take from inside this stitch. Okay, I'll take a small portion. I'll take the needle like this. Again, I'll take the thread from the left to the right under the needle, and you can see a chain stitch. So you can see the difference between the two stitches. Here I have made a chain stitch using all the 6 strands. See, it is something like that, very bulging. But here you see it is so delicate. So that's what I wanted to show you using both the strands. So once you finish this, it looks very classic. So now I'll be showing you this lazy daisy design. For that, I have used 6 strands here so that our design looks bold. So this is used for making tiny flowers, as I told you. So I just taken the thread like this. Now I had to make a chain stitch only. You can see this line. So I will just take this, I'll just poke the needle inside and I will take it out like this at the end of this pencil mark, and I'll just pull this out, and you can see a big chain like this. See, now what I had to secure this in position, I'll just poke it inside like this. So you can see, I'll show you again. I poked the needle from under the fabric to the top like this. Now I'll poke it again and then bring it out towards this end like this. See, so we form a big chain like this, and then I'll secure this chain by poking the thread inside like this. So this forms a tiny petal. So this comes in very handy when you make small flowers or small leaves. I'll show you once again. You have to make a big chain, that's all, like this. And then you poke this inside. Keep the thread to your left side. And then all the stitches are very easy, and once you get a hang of things, you can do it very quickly. See, our very small flower is ready. See, it will look something like this. And here you can see that I have done a design, lazy daisy design. This is the flower. So this is the lazy daisy design. So I'll show you this hanky. You can see the entire this portion I have used this lazy daisy design to make small flowers. And this is one advantage of embroidery. You can make hankies like this, and you can use the simple embroidery stitches, and then you can give it as a present, maybe to your mother or to your sister or whoever, those people who are interested in all this. And then you can see this mask. This is again a handmade mask, and I have made use of chain stitch. You can see chain stitch and this lazy daisy designs. Here I have used this lazy daisy design for making small leaves like this, and then the other fillings or other embroidery stitches, basically chain stitch. Here of course I have used a satin stitch, which I am not discussing today. I'll be showing that in my next video. And now we'll start with our last item, that is the stem stitch. I've taken the needle from below to the top, and now I'll just poke the thread like needle like this, and then I'll take it out like this. See, I'll show you. So you see, this is something like a running stitch, but I have poked the needle around the middle of this stitch. See, and now pull it, and then again you can see this, when I poke it inside, the stitch will be till here. So towards the middle of that stitch, I'll take this needle out. See, it will be something like this. And this stitch is also a very sturdy stitch, and you can use this for joining two pieces of fabric together. See, our stem stitch will be like this. So you can see our stem stitch is something like this. So as I told you, this is a very strong stitch, and you can use this stitch also for joining two pieces of fabric. All this mask, I have made use of this particular stitch for joining the two pieces of fabric. I'll show you. See, all this, these two pieces I have joined using this particular stem stitch. That is, I have kept both these pieces together, and just like this. And we'll assume that it is a single unit, and we'll do the embroidery. First, I'll do from here to here, and then from back from here to here. So once you do this stitches two times, it is as strong as any machine stitch. So I hope today you got a fair idea of some of the very basic stitches. Most of the stitches many of us must have learned right when we were in the school days. But then, so you can say it is just a brushing up of all the skills that we acquired long ago. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope it was of some use to you. In case you have any doubts regarding the stitches, you can get back to me in the comment section. I will try to clarify your doubts to the best of my ability. So till my next video, it is Tata bye bye from me. But as usual, you have to keep supporting me with your likes, shares and subscriptions. Have a nice day. Bye bye.